Thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. I'm Nick Barber. We'll start this week with Sony's new virtual reality headset called Project Morpheus. The project is still in the development stage, but Sony revealed some hardware specs. The head unit will have a 5-inch LCD display with a field of view of 90 degrees and a resolution of 1080p. It will also feature an accelerometer, gyroscope, HDMI and USB connectors, and 3D sound that changes what the player hears depending on head direction. An SDK for Morpheus is under development, and with more on the project, it's over to my colleague Melissa Aparicio. Melissa?
Thanks, Nick. I'm at the Game Developers Conference in San Francisco, and we were able to talk to some people who tried Project Morpheus. Here's what they had to say.
The depth was very good. It was fantastic. That was the most important thing, I think, that makes the difference, is that you can focus very close, like there were the bubbles in the deep demo, but you can also see very far away, like there was the wreck. The PS Move, I mean, they had to recalibrate some things, but it was really impressive how it tracked, like, how I was moving the rest of my body, not just my hands.
Absolutely phenomenal. It's just really, I just lost myself in there for like the brief time. I felt genuine fear when I was in the deep, because I'm looking around, looking for the shark. The second one, which was the crossbow and the sword, the sensation of having something tactile in your hands with having the Move controller when you're actually using them as swords is just phenomenal.
And it's not the only virtual reality here. Oculus is showing its latest headset. I had a chance to talk to the founder, and I asked him if virtual reality is the next big thing in gaming.
I think it's the last big thing in gaming. If you can have perfect virtual reality, and we're not perfect virtual reality, but if you can get there, what other innovation could there be? I mean, you can simulate everything you could do in the real world and everything you can't do. People will make new games, new gameplay ideas, but in terms of hardware and, you know, hardware improvements, and VR will eventually be the final step.
I also asked him what he thinks about Sony's Project Morpheus.
It's really cool to see other people entering the VR space. We'll see, you know, when we know more about the price, weight, when it's shipping.
And there you have it, Nick. A lot of virtual reality here at GDC. Back to you in Boston.
Thanks, Melissa. Staying with gaming news, Mark Witten, Xbox product officer in charge of all the Xbox launches in the company's history, has left Microsoft for Sonos. The Xbox One has trailed Sony's PlayStation 4 in both January and February sales in the US. And just 2 weeks ago, Jack Tretton, in charge of PlayStation, announced his resignation. Google has kicked off an effort to bring Android to wearable devices, reminding everyone that the OS is not just for tablets and smartphones. Google's Android Wear will initially focus on getting manufacturers to use Android Wear in smartwatches, but it will extend those efforts to a wide range of body-fitting devices. Smartwatches powered by Android Wear will come later this year. Google is working with companies including Fossil, Asus, LG, HTC, Motorola, Samsung, Intel, MediaTek, and Qualcomm on those smartwatches. One of the first devices based on Android Wear is Moto 360, Motorola's first smartwatch. The smartwatch will become available in the summer of this year, the company said. Staying with Google, the company's multimedia streaming device called Chromecast is now available in 11 more countries, including France, Germany, and the UK. The Chromecast is a thumb-sized media streaming device that plugs into the HDMI port of a TV. Apple replaced the iPad 2 with the fourth generation Retina iPad as its lowest priced tablet, a likely reaction to both pressure from cheap Android tablets and the advanced age of the iPad 2. The fourth generation iPad was priced at $399 with 16 gigabytes of storage space. Apple had kept the iPad 2 in inventory so it could offer a tablet at a lower price than its flagship, now the iPad Air, which lists for $499. Satya Nadella will hold his first press conference as Microsoft CEO next week, and reports are emerging that he'll unveil a version of the Office Suite for Apple's iPad. Nadella will appear at a press event in San Francisco next Thursday to discuss news focused on the intersection of cloud and mobile computing, according to a Microsoft invitation being sent to reporters. The invitation makes no mention of Office or the iPad, and a Microsoft spokeswoman declined to say what will be discussed at the event. IBM is using the powers of its Watson supercomputer service to help solve the mysteries of brain cancer by examining individual genetic mutations. In a research study, IBM Watson will help New York Genome Center doctors by searching for their patients' mutations that may be referenced in genomic databases and in medical literature. It can then present any findings of interest to the patient's physician. The patients being studied have glioblastoma, an aggressively malignant brain cancer that kills more than 13,000 people in the U.S. each year.
We have the potential for sequencing tens of thousands of patients, maybe up to a million, depending on how we do it, per year. If we can get any traction at all and show an improvement for 10 or 20% of patients, it'll be a huge success. If we are on the right mark, this will scale not only quantitatively, but qualitatively, from glioblastoma to other tumor types.
Doctors will upload the gene sequence to the system, which runs on the IBM cloud. Watson will then scan mutation databases and medical literature for those types of mutations, connecting and highlighting any possible relevant findings. Thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. For the IDG News Service, I'm Nick Barber.